Hello. In this video, I'm going to show you a couple of new features we have implemented in eSankey 5. Tiny options actually, but I think quite helpful to give the finishing touch to your Sankey diagram. Now, to show you these new options, I'm just going to draw a small Sankey diagram, two processes, an arrow, and I'm going to drag a number of entries I've prepared onto the arrow. The arrow label appears next to the middle segment of the arrow, and as you start entering values as flow quantities, you see that the Sankey arrow actually collides with the label. So what you would probably do is just pull away the label a little bit so that it looks nice again. Well, you do have some wiggle room there. For example, if you change a value, this might still be okay. But imagine, for example, you change the scale of the overall diagram, as I do it here, and again, the arrow will run into the label. This is where the new option label follows arrow width comes in. You can find it in the properties of the label. Just switch it on, and then as I change the scale of the arrow, the label stays bound to the edge of the arrow and it moves along nicely as the magnitude of the arrow changes. So the second option I want to show you relates to the process height. In the same way as we have the issue with the arrow label, we want the height of the process to adapt to the width of the arrow. We have a manual option for this in the process properties, but of course you want to do it automatically so that the process adapts when the size, when the width of the arrow changes. In the process properties, you now find an option auto adapt width and height. Now it's important to point out that this option is only available if the connectivity is other than free. For example, left to right. I'm going to switch on auto adapt width to height, and as I change the scale, the process height just comes along with the arrow width. A very nice feature, quite helpful. The third option we have introduced in eSankey 5, I'm going to show it to you at a slightly different example. We have two straight arrow lines. Now, some of you might know the issue that as I introduce an additional arrow that branches out from one process and or goes to another process, we get a slight slope along this arrow line. You can see that. Maybe you can see it better if I introduce a value here, let's say 3 kilograms. And you see, as the arrow snuggles in underneath, it pushes up the other arrow, so this arrow is not straight. We have thought we should introduce a good option here, and we have done so by allowing the arrows to connect at the top or at the bottom of the process. I'm going to select the process here and in the connectivity section choose horizontal connectivity top, and for the ones at the bottom choose connectivity bottom. And as you can see, those arrows are straight again because the processes are now aligned and the arrows connect at the bottom or at the top rather than along the center line. So all in all, those three new options with the arrow label following the width and the process height following, that makes for a very nice effect. I'm gonna compare the old possibilities with the new ones by copying the whole diagram, and on the left side you'll see the new options, on the right side without the new options. And as I change the scale of this diagram, on the left hand side the diagram adapts nicely, while at the other one the processes remain fixed both in position as well as in height, so do the arrow labels. It makes for a different effect.